In Atsuki Village, a village being burned due to a virus, Shino, Sosuke, and Hamaji have to make a difficult decision after a mysterious man offers them a sword if they want to live. 5 years later, Shino is bathing in a river when he sees Murasami trying to eat a strange eyeball. He throws it away and returns to the church where they are now living. Meanwhile, Sosuke is delivering a parcel to a house in the village. On his way back, Kenta, a village boy, accompanies him. As thanks, Sosuke gives Kenta a necklace. When Kenta heads back, he passes through the forest and gets confused when he sees Shino with a ghostly appearance. At the church, Sosuke and Shino receive a summons from the church headquarters. All of a sudden, the eyeball Murasame was trying to eat returns wanting to be Shino's friend. The next morning, 5 fox-masked men arrive pretending to be their escorts. Shino summons Murasame out of his arm and attacks the 5, making them disappear. Afterward, Kenta arrives to tell them that 3 men had disappeared into the forests. Sosuke gets alarmed and warns Kenta to never return. Kenta leaves in anger and throws away the necklace Sosuke gave him. When Sosuke learns that Kenta removed his necklace, he immediately changes into a dog and runs after him. In the forest, Shino finds Sosuke in a web and a ghostly Shino is attached to a large spider. Shino and Sosuke rescue Kenta, with Shino transforming Murasame into a sword. They defeat the spider and bring Kenta back to his family. When they return to the church, they learn that the 5 foxes have taken Hamaji. The 5 are the Goko 5 foxes of the Osaki family, one of the 4 houses of the sacred beasts. The next day, Shino and Sosuke ride a train heading to the imperial capital. Sosuke and Shino were met by Ryo Satomi in the capital. Ryo brings them to an inn, but Shino immediately leaves to look around. Shino passes by the Shogetsu Institute, but he gets flattened when a guy named Kobungo was unceremoniously thrown out by monks. Kobungo was trying to beg the monks to release his friend, Genpachi, who was captured on suspicion of being a demon. Kobungo then treats Shino to a meal to apologize for crashing into him. The next day, Shino wakes up to find Ryo and his dog in his room. Ryo laments that Shino hasn't aged at all even though 5 years have passed. He warns him that this might be an effect of Murasame in his body. During breakfast, Ryo also informs them that Hamaji is in the 4 houses manor. There, they meet Hamaji, who was enjoying her stay after being kidnapped by Kaname Osaki. Kaname apologizes to Sosuke and Shino and invites them on a tour of the city. Meanwhile, a monk named Saren is using spirit bugs to secretly observe them. Saren heads to the dungeon and tortures Genpachi so that he'll reveal his demon form. Meanwhile, Shino and the others are now living in the 4 houses manor. Sosuke asks Shino how he knows Ryo, and Shino explains that he was the one who gave him Murasame. The next day, Shino and Sosuke are exploring the city. When they pass by the police station, Kobungo suddenly gets thrown out and hits Shino again. Kobungo was complaining that his friend Genpachi was fired from the military for being rumored to be a demon. That night, Sosuke and Shino meet with Ryo to ask why he summoned them to the capital in the first place. Ryo shows them a pair of gems and Shino recognizes them as their own gems from when they were kids. Ryo explains that there are 6 other gems like those and he wants them to find them. The gems date back from Princess Fuse, a folktale legend. Sosuke readily accepts the quest and leaves. At the Shozetsu Institute, Genpachi can't tolerate the torture anymore and transforms into a demon. The demon goes berserk and smells his spirit he wants to eat. This turns out to be Murasame's smell on Shino. Shino leads him outside the village, but when the demon touches him, Shino realizes he is a human. Meanwhile, villagers band together to hunt the demon with Saren in the lead. The mob attacks Shino and Sosuke saves him, but they all fall to a river. Shino, Sosuke, and Genpachi were saved from drowning by the strange eyeball. Kobungo then hides them in a house in the forest. Kobungo explains to them that he and Genpachi were the only survivors of a military expedition after a demon attacked their group. After that, Kobungo and Genpachi's bodies became immortal. Meanwhile, Kaname accompanies Hamaji, who wants to go to school. On their way back, some bugs attack Hamaji, but Kaname saves her. In the forest, Genpachi feeds the strange eyeball and names it Megu. They were then alerted when the forces of Siren surrounded their house. Kobungo and Genpachi fight the monks while Shino and Sosuke escape. Siren taunts Genpachi until he transforms into a demon. However, the demon is too strong and Siren runs away. Before he can escape, Kaname appears and kills him for hurting Hamaji. Shino sees the burning house and uses Murasame to summon a rainstorm, saving both Kobungo and Genpachi. A few days later, Shino wakes up in the 4 houses manor, but he can't find the bathroom. He gets lost in another wing, but Ryo finds him and warns him not to go to that wing since there is another master there. Later, he heads to the kitchen but bumps into a white-haired girl. The girl sees Murasame in his arm and flees in terror. Kaname later explains that she's Ayan, chosen by the snake spirit. Hajime sends Shino to Ayan in the other wing to apologize and invite her to tea. However, the snake spirit, Chikage, attacks him for trespassing. Sosuke arrives to apologize on his behalf, but Chikage wants Sosuke's arm as payment. Ayan then arrives and scolds Chikage for being too strict on visitors. Ayan apologizes and becomes good friends with Shino and Hamaji. Ayan then wants to leave the house to go to a festival with Hamaji. Shino speaks with Chikage to ask permission on her behalf, and they compromise that Chikage can use Osaki's foxes as proxies to accompany Ayan outside the house. As thanks for taking care of Ayan, Chikage shows her true self to Shino and gives him one of her scales. Shino reads in a newspaper about a story of a group of men who became lost on a mountain, but were guided back to civilization by a woman. Afterward, the same virus that befell Atsuki Village kills the men. Shino becomes curious and decides to visit the mountain. At the mountain, Shino's gems start glowing. This distracts Shino and he falls down the mountainside. Meanwhile, a group of musicians stops at the village near the mountain for a festival. One of these musicians is a man named Asakino. Asakino cannot escape the memories of someone killing his family. Back in the city, Sosuke, Kobungo, and Jinpachi follow Shino. Shino wakes up in the mountains with one of the gems missing. He meets the large monkey spirit protecting the mountain and asks for his help, but the monkey just gives him a large gold ore. Sosuke and the others arrive and bring Shino down to the mountain. When they reach the village, they get imprisoned for fear that they might also be infected. The two doctors, Akane and Joji, check up on them. Joji recognizes them since he also served in the military. Asakino also sees them and recognizes Sosuke as the man who killed his family. The next day, the group is moved to the church and Asakino confronts Sosuke with swords drawn. Shino defends Sosuke from Asakino. Asakino's guardian, Kokono, arrives and tells him that Sosuke isn't the man she's looking for. To apologize, Kokono promises to help Shino find his missing gem. The next day, Shino's group gets kidnapped by villagers who saw the gold he brought from the mountains. They want him to lead them back to get more. In the mountains, the monkey attacks the villagers and kills them. He is angry since the friend he had before never came back. The doctor, Akane, arrives and speaks with the monkey. She was the monkey's old friend, but she stopped visiting when she grew up. Kokono then finds and returns Shino's gem, and the group returns to the capital the next day. Sosuke and Shino are riding the train going back to the capital. They share a booth with a young man named Dosetsu. A little while later, a drunkard tries to join their booth, but Shino kicks him out for being rude. At another train station, a monk rides the train, but he smells some spirits. He explores the train and ends up in Shino's booth. He shouts at the three spirits inside, but a snow princess suddenly materializes on Dosetsu and freezes the monk. Dosetsu worries that Sosuke and Shino might now be afraid of him, but Shino suddenly speaks with the snow princess like a long-lost friend. Shino tells him that she saved him before when he was lost in the snow. Dosetsu asks them to convince the snow princess to leave him alone since his social life was destroyed because he always felt like winter. Unfortunately, Shino tells him that he'll die if the snow princess leaves. Dosetsu realizes that he did indeed collapse in the snow looking for his sister and the snow princess saved him. Shino tries to tell Dosetsu something, but the snow princess stops her. The train reaches the capital and Shino and Sosuke disembark. Shino gets sad because the snow princess lost her voice in exchange for saving Dosetsu's life. One day, Hamaji is going to an all-girls school and Sosuke bakes her some muffins. However, she forgets some books, so Shino breaks into the school that night to deliver them. Meanwhile, Hamaji meets her roommate Suzu. Shino gives Hamaji her books, but when he's about to leave, he suddenly falls unconscious. The next day, he tells the others he saw a ghost doll, but the others just laugh at him. At school, Hamaji meets the student prefect, Ruri. Ruri tells her that the school has a guard, so she shouldn't go out at night. That night, Asakino, Shino, and Sosuke come back to the school to check out the ghost guarding it. A doll ghost does appear and starts throwing lightning at them. Sosuke apologizes to the doll and tells it that they just want to make sure their friend Hamaji is safe. The next day, Suzu tells Hamaji that his friends are pretty cool, so she doesn't really need her hanging around. Later, Ruri invites Hamaji for lunch, but Hamaji declines since she plans to have lunch with Suzu. However, Ruri gets confused since Hamaji shouldn't have a roommate. When Hamaji returns to her room, she finds a doll in her bed. At church, Shino accompanies Sosuke to perform the anointing of the citizens. There, he meets Kohaku, a pretty gold-eyed girl, and he gives her a pendant. In the city, Asakino sees someone he thinks was his family's killer, but when he chases after him, he mysteriously disappears. That night, Shino bumps into Asakino and learns that his heart was taken when his family was attacked. In replacement, Kokono's heart is the one in Asakino's body. The next day, Kohaku wakes up coughing up blood. A strange man wearing Sosuke's face appears and offers to prolong her life in exchange for her eye. In the city, Shino, Asakino, and Genpachi meet with the Sosuke lookalike. He speaks with Shino like a long-lost friend and leaves. Later, Shino goes to Ryo and asks him if he knows anything about the Sosuke lookalike. Ryo reveals that it is Sosuke's shadow since Sosuke is currently missing half a soul. He would need to capture Sosuke's shadow and combine the two souls, or his fragmented soul would be drawn into the underworld. The next day, Kohaku meets with his boss and tells him about Shino and Sosuke. His boss then lures Shino to her to make Kohaku happy, but Kohaku gets angry instead. The two argue and Shino is mistakenly shot in the neck. Murasane activates and devours the boss. Genpachi arrives at the crime scene and takes away the bleeding Shino. Later, Shino wakes up surrounded by the others. He is nonchalant about his near-death experience, injuring Sosuke, who slaps him. Later, Shino notices that Murasane was spreading in his arm. The next day, Ryo sees Shino transform into his 18-year-old self and attacks him, looking for more souls to consume. At Kohaku's workplace, Kohaku collapses after feeling a burning sensation in her throat. Her co-worker comes to help her, but instead, Kohaku attacks her. Kohaku wakes up the next day with blood all over her. Meanwhile, Kaname sees Ryo bloodied after Shino attacks him. He brings him a change of clothes while Shino recuperates in his bed. Kohaku takes refuge in the church after news of her co-worker's death spreads throughout the town. She laments all of her problems to Sosuke in the church, from being sold to a brothel when she was a child, killing her friend. While she is sharing all her problems, a pair of wings slowly grows on her back. It turns out she had taken a deal a few days back to prolong her life in exchange for her eye. Shino then arrives and compliments her, telling her that she's not a monster, and she looks like an angel instead. Shino then summons Murasame and ends Kohaku's suffering. Sosuke consoles Shino, and after a while, Shino reverts to his 12-year-old self. Due to the controversies of a boy surviving a gunshot wound, the church elders decide to summon Shino. Meanwhile, Shino is strolling around the city when Sosuke's shadow suddenly grabs him. He tries to prove that he is the real Sosuke by telling Shino memories from their past. Shino asks him if it's true that he took Asakino's heart. Sosuke's shadow nods and also shows his eye that came from Kohaku. He tells Shino that he's trying to build a body since the other Kosu took most of it. He then hugs Shino and leaves. Later, Shino and Sosuke learn that Hamiji was taken to the church headquarters to convince Shino to go there. Shino breaks in, but he encounters the church's guardian, a woman named Lilith. The two start fighting and Lilith binds Shino, but Shino severs her binds using Murasame. Shino then runs away to hide from Lilith. He encounters Ryo, who hides him in his robes. Ryo then helps him meet Hamiji and take them home. That night, Asakino discovers that he, Kobongo, and Genpachi, aside from having the same stories of being the only survivors, also have the gems that Shino was looking for. Shino was excited to learn this, but he finds out that his own gems were pickpocketed by Sosuke's shadow and he hugged him before. Thus, the race to gather all the gems continues.